Recently here in New South Wales, Australia, we have the case of a New South Wales baby that dies after doctors refuse to listen to mother's intuition. This case goes back to 2013. It involves a six-month-year-old boy who was initially diagnosed with gastroenteritis. Now, this turned out to be an obstructed bowel, and the child died with a lack of oxygen flow to the brain. Mr. and Mrs. Day, right here, knew that something more was going on, but there was a lack of testing and subsequently the child died. If we go to England in the mid to late 1990s, we had Dr. Andrew Wakefield over there, a gastroenterologist, along with a team who were looking at the bowels of children with autism. And they also suspected that the MMR vaccine may have something to do with the diagnosis of autism. And I certainly think this is the case with vaccinations. But beyond that, the mothers over there in particular weren't listened to, or the parents. Andrew Wakefield, who did listen to them, was relieved of his right to practice medicine in England. And that's basically the way it rolls. So there's just so much sort of corruption within medicine. Medicine provides some really good aspects, but there is so much corruption as well. Along the lines of corruption, we also have Dr. William Thompson coming out from the CDC and speaking of corruption regarding a study there regarding autism and vaccines, and that's another story in itself. A lot of arrogance and a lot of corruption within medicine. It's a really sad state of affairs, and I think things are going to have to get a whole lot worse, unfortunately, before they get better.